YouTube asks the FTC to clarify how video creators should comply with COPPA ruling. YouTube is asking the US Federal Trade Commission for further clarification and better guidance to help video creators understand how to comply with the FTC's guidelines set forth as part of YouTube's settlement with the regulator over its violations of children's privacy laws. The FTC in September imposed a historic fine of $170 million for YouTube's violations of COPPA, the U.S. Children's Online Privacy Protection Act. It additionally required YouTube creators to now properly identify any child-directed content on the platform. To comply with the ruling, YouTube created a system where creators could either label their entire channel as child-directed, or they could identify only certain videos as being directed at children, as needed. Videos that are considered child-directed content would then be prohibited from collecting personal data from viewers. This limited creators' ability to leverage Google's highly profitable behavioral advertising technology on videos kids were likely to watch. As a result, YouTube creators have been in an uproar since the ruling, arguing that it's too difficult to tell the difference between what's child-directed content and what's not. Several popular categories of YouTube videos, like gaming, toy reviews, and family vlogging, for instance, fall under gray areas, where they're watched by children and adults alike. But because the FTC's ruling left creators held liable for any future violations, YouTube could only advise creators to consult a lawyer to help them work through the ruling's impact on their own channels. Today, YouTube says it's asking the FTC to provide more clarity. Currently, the FTC's guidance requires platforms must treat anyone watching primarily child-directed content as children under 13. This does not match what we see on YouTube, where adults watch favorite cartoons from their childhood or teachers look for content to share with their students, noted YouTube in an announcement. Creators of such videos have also conveyed the value of product features that wouldn't be supported on their content. For example, creators have expressed the value of using comments to get helpful feedback from older viewers. This is why we support allowing platforms to treat adults as adults if there are measures in place to help confirm that the user is an adult viewing kids' content, the company said. Specifically, YouTube wants the FTC to clarify what's to be done when adults are watching kids' content. It also wants to know what's to be done about content that doesn't intentionally target kids, like videos in the gaming, DIY and art space, for example, if those videos end up attracting a young audience. Are these also to be labeled made for kids, even though that's not their intention? For more on this story, visit the news article link.